Hello everyone! We are going to learn how to interpret graphs in this video. In the exam, there are often questions involving graphs. You will learn three skills in this video: describing graphs, comparing sets of graphical data, and making deductions from graphs. We will guide you through this process with an example involving line graphs. To describe a line graph, you may start by dividing the x-axis into faces. Describe the trends shown in the graph face by face. For example, a quantity may increase, decrease, fluctuate, or remain constant. Point out any maximum or minimum. They usually occur when the trend changes. Let's take a look at this graph. Alan is a healthy person. This graph shows the changes in his blood glucose level after he had fasted for 12 hours and then drank a glucose solution. We may divide this graph into two faces and mention three points. First, from 9 o'clock to 10 o'clock, Alan's blood glucose level increased. Second, at 10 o'clock, his blood glucose level reached a maximum. Lastly, from 10 to 12 o'clock, his blood glucose level decreased to roughly the starting level. Let's look at the changes in the blood glucose level of one more person. Ben is diabetic. He had fasted for 12 hours and then drank a glucose solution. The glucose solution was of equal concentration and volume as the one Alan drank. We will need to compare different sets of data shown in the same graph. What should we look for when we compare the data? First, we should compare the starting points. This graph shows that Ben's blood glucose level was already higher than Alan's at the start. Note the use of the comparative adjective, higher, to clearly show the comparison. Then, compare the slopes of different lines, which indicate the rates at which variables increase or decrease. Ben's blood glucose level increased faster than Alan's. We should also compare the maxima. Ben's blood glucose level reached a higher maximum than Alan's. Then, compare the time at which the maxima occur. Ben's blood glucose level reached a maximum later than Alan's. Finally, compare the ending points. Ben's blood glucose level was higher at the end and did not return to its original level as Alan's did. Some students may answer, "Ben's blood glucose level returned to normal later." While this statement may be true, the graph did not show that Ben's blood glucose level returned to normal, and therefore, this is an incorrect answer. Apart from description and comparison, exam questions may require candidates to make logical deductions or draw conclusions from graphical data. Let's look at one more graph, which shows the changes in Alan's and Ben's blood insulin levels between 9 o'clock and 12 o'clock. We will demonstrate how to deduce the type of diabetes Ben has. Some students may focus only on figure 2 and miss the information in figure 1 upon seeing questions asking about the types of diabetes. Note that figure 1 shows that Ben's blood glucose level was higher than Alan's and increased faster. Ben's body should have responded by producing more insulin. His blood insulin should at least have reached a level similar to Alan's, if not even higher. However, figure 2 shows that Ben's blood insulin level was lower than Alan's and only showed little change. This means Ben failed to produce the normal amount of insulin that a healthy person can produce. Hence, we can deduce that Ben suffers from insulin-dependent diabetes, or type 1 diabetes. Bear in mind that we may need to integrate information from different graphs to obtain enough evidence when we make deductions. We have learned how to interpret graphs. If you enjoyed this video, do give us a like and share this video to your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching. See you next time.